Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over a few of the reasons why VLOOKUP may not be working in Microsoft Excel.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
So the first reason VLOOKUP may not be working is because you may have a mismatch in what your data types are from the value that you're looking up to the column where you are doing the lookup. So let me show you an example right here. If I type equals VLOOKUP with a left parenthesis, and I click on this value up here because this is the value that I want to look up, and then I type a comma, and then I highlight column A and B because this is the range where I want to look my data up. And then I type a comma and I type 2 here because I want to return the second value. And then I'm going to do comma false to return an exact match and close my parentheses. Now, if I hit enter, I'm going to get an error right here. Now, let's look at this a little more closely. See how this number right here is left aligned? This number, if I click in this cell, if I go up to the format, is formatted as number. However, if I go over to these values here in column A, and I can also see that I have a little triangle in the upper left-hand corner, as well as a warning sign right here when I click in any of these cells. So if I click on this cell, I can see that I have an apostrophe here before my main number. So I'm just going to delete this apostrophe out. For each of the values in my first column where I'm doing the match. And now I can see that this value here is recognized because I am being returned with the first name. So as long as this cell is left aligned because it's being recognized as a number, and this cell over here is left aligned also appearing as a number, then Excel is able to do the VLOOKUP.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
A second example I would like to show you is when we do not use the exact match argument, sometimes that can return an error with VLOOKUP. So if I type equals VLOOKUP with a left parenthesis and I click in the employee ID here, type a comma, highlight my array, type another comma, and then return column index 2 because I want the second column to be returned. Now I'm going to not type a comma and not put in the range lookup argument right here and close my parentheses and hit enter. I can see that I'm trying to look up 1020, but when I go over here to look up 1020, I shouldn't be returned with the name Jonah. If I look down here, 1011 is where Jonah actually is. But I really need VLOOKUP to be returning Emily. So let's click here and click in my formula again, right before the final parenthesis. Type a comma, and let's type false for exact match. And just hit enter. I can now see I am being returned with Emily because I have required that this number exactly match what's found in column A. A third issue people sometimes have with VLOOKUP is the order that the columns are in for the data. VLOOKUP requires that the field you are returning be to the right of the field that you are looking up. But what if we have this case where we have DOJ to the right of the data that we wish to return? So if I type in here and I go equals VLOOKUP with a left parenthesis, and let's say I want to look up this value, comma, when I go to select my table array, say I select this entire table, and then I type a comma, on my next argument, I'm going to be asked for column index number. Now, the column index number is how many columns to the right are you looking for? And if you notice right here, DOJ does not have any columns to the right. So we are going to run into a problem right here because we don't have an answer for the column index number. Plus, on top of that, the value that I'm trying to look up actually has to appear in the first column right here where I have selected my table array, and the date is just not there. So Excel is going to try to look up this date up here in G1 in the employee ID column, because that is the first column I have selected. So that's not going to work. So what we would have to do here, I could just move this DOJ field. If I right click and go to cut, and then right click on column A and go to insert cut cells, and then I type equals VLOOKUP with a left parenthesis, click this value, type a comma, and then create my table array here. And then when I type a comma and I'm asked for my column index number, I can enter a 3 because I am looking to return the third column, A being 1, B being 2, and C being 3. And then don't forget to type a comma and type false here for the exact match. Close your parentheses and hit enter. And you will see that I am also returned with the correct value here. Another function I can use is XLOOKUP. Now, XLOOKUP is only available in Microsoft 365 and not any of the earlier versions of Excel. So if I type in equals XLOOKUP with a left parenthesis, now I can click on this is the value that I want to look up, comma. I'm going to look that value up in column D, so I'm going to select that, and then I'm going to type a comma, and I'm going to return column B. And then I'm going to close my parentheses and hit enter. And I can see that I am being returned with Bruce, which is the first name that I have found on 119. If you are using a version that is less than 365, you will not be able to use XLOOKUP, but you will be able to use the index function with the match function. And we go over that on our blog in the link below if you're interested. Also on our blog are a few other scenarios where VLOOKUP may not be working for you. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.